students, how are you all? I hope you are perfectly fine and doing your studies at your home. Students, this is Somitri Yadav, assistant teacher of Lakshmi Prasad Memorial Public School, which is situated in Golan Bazaar, Gorakhpur. Students, I am here with a new online video class in which we will discuss some exercise of chapter number 7, which is Down the Wall Climber. So, without any delay, we will start our video. So, on the page number 67, you have found some exercise related to this chapter. Question number A, B and C. You will write all this question answer in your CW copy and as well as in your peer copy. Now move to page number 68. On the page number 68, you have given question number D, which is circle the correct suffix that can be added to these words. You can circle more than one. So firstly we will discuss what a suffix is. A suffix is a letter or a group of letters that creates a new word when added at the end of a word. Like bottom, when we add less at the end of given word bottom, it becomes a new word, that is bottomless. Move, when we have added men at the end of given word move, it becomes a new word, that is movement. Okay, so these are meant, less, these are suffix. So let's start doing this exercise. First is given word. So for hard word, you will circle on less. Okay. Second, comfort. You will circle able. Punish. You will circle meant. Fourth, you will circle full. Fifth, you will circle ing, being. Season, you will circle al. Sharp, you will circle en. Kid, hand, you will circle full. So first is heartless, second is comfortable, third is punishment, fourth is peaceful, fifth is training, sixth is seasonal, seventh is sharpened, eighth is handful. Now moving to the next exercise, question number E is make complete words from these words and suffix. You can look up the new word in the dictionary to check if its spelling is correct. Okay, so you have given analysis plus sys, and when we complete it, when we add it, it becomes analysis. A-N-I-L-Y-S-I-S. Second is caution plus us, it becomes cautious. Biology plus icon, it becomes biological. Fourth is happiness, it becomes happiness. Active plus eating, it becomes activity. Sixth, tense plus ion, it becomes tension. Brave plus hurry, bravery. Organized plus ation, it becomes organization. Okay, now move to the next exercise, which is exercise number F. So in the exercise number F, you have to punctuate this paragraph correctly and rewrite it in your notebook. Use capital letters, comma, full stop and question mark where needed. So you have given students a paragraph in your book and you have to punctuate it. So do you know what a volcano is? So you will write D in capital letter, then after no you will put comma, and after is you will put interrogative symbol. Now a volcano is a mountain which is hollow inside and open it at this top. So you will write A in a capital letter, then after top you will put full stop. Now next, this after full stop you can see write it in capital letter and no, K N O W. After no, you will put comma. What happens when a volcano erupts? Hot gases, ash, and molten rock. Okay, hot gases, ash, and after gases, you will put comma. Okay, hot gases, comma, ash, and molten rock from below the earth's surface shoot upwards. And after upwards, you will put question mark. And after upwards, you will write day in capital letter. They pour out of the crater in the form of lava. And after lava, you will put full stop. And you will write a in capital letter. An erupting volcano can cause a lot of destruction through earthquakes. After earthquake, you will put comma, landslides and falling rocks. And after rock, you will put full stop. Now moving to the question number G. Fill in the blanks with the simple present form of the verb in the brackets. So friends, you have given a paragraph and in the bracket you have given some words and you have to fill in the blanks with the simple present form of the verb. So let's start first. Annie and Tara are late for school. Tara grabs her school bag and asks Annie to hurry up. They run towards the door. Their mother tells them to stop rushing. The two girls call out a hasty goodbye. Annie wants to cut across the park, but Tara knows a shorter route. They take that route and it saves them a lot of time. Seconds before the school bell rings, the two reach the school. So this was the exercise number G. Now move to question number I. Complete the sentence with the present perfect form of the verbs in the brackets. And in the present perfect tense, you will use has or have, and also the third form of the verb. Has and have, you will use it according to the subject. If subject is singular, you will use has. Okay, and if the subject is plural, you will use have. Okay, and the form of the verb, that will be only third form. Now let's start. First is, you blank gained great courage, my boy, said Professor Little Rock to Axel. So you have showed. DP blank the inter-school debate competition this year. So DP is singular, so we will write a has. Okay, and the third form of win is won. Vani and Arna blank home from their month-long motorcycle tour of India. So the subjects are plural, so we will use here have and return. The notice is that the shop blank to another address. So you will write here has moved. Fifth is, I cannot find my bicycle key. I think I have dropped it somewhere. Okay. Now moving to the question number J, that is listening and speaking skill. So question number J is, your teacher will read out a passage. Listen carefully and write the answer for these questions. Students, you have given this exercise on the last page of your book, and the page number is 118. Okay, and you have to write the answer of these questions. Okay, I am reading the paragraph, then we will write the question answer of this question. So let's start. I am reading the paragraph. On the page number 118, you can see the paragraph which has been taken from the chapter down the volume. So years ago, our planet was without any life. The first to live on land were plants and primitive insects like giant dragonflies. Insects were also the first to develop wings about 50 million years before words appeared. For more than 200 million years, the earth was ruled by the reptile group known as dinosaurs. Birds and mammals are the dominant life forms on earth today. Humans only appeared on earth about 2 million years ago. So this is the paragraph. Now let's move to the question answer. So which insects were the first to live on land? So answer is plants and primitive insects like giant dragon flies. Okay. Moving to the second question. Which creatures developed wings before bird appeared? So answer is insects. Okay. Third is, which reptiles ruled the earth for more than 200 million ago? So answer is dinosaurs. Okay. Fourth is, what are the dominant life forms on earth today? That is, answer is birds and mammals. Okay. Birds and mammals are the dominant life forms on earth today. Which creature appeared on earth only 2 million years ago? So answer is humans. Okay. So these are the exercise of chapter number 7. You will fill your book and then you will write all the exercise in your HW copy. So for today's video lecture, that's it. We will meet soon with another video lecture. We will cover the revisional videos of revisional video from chapter number 1. Till then, you will complete your fair copy. Goodbye, everyone.